Good morning, everyone. Kailana Sidrani Alanese here once again. I've been thinking lately, reading stories in the news, locally, well, not so much local, but in my state. And this video is intersex related, gay and transgender related, and bisexual related, and you know, it's society related. I title it Intersex, Teaching Our Children. Our public education system teaches kids about boys and girls. You know, boys are XY and girls are XX. And our religious organizations teach our kids that there are men and there are women. And you're either one or the other. Fact is, not everyone is male, and not everyone is female. But our society doesn't like accepting people who are different. You know, we have this, you know, 6.4 whatever billion people in the world, and each and every one of us is different. You know, none of us are exactly one thing. You know, we have a whole lot of different possibilities, you know, of what we can be. You know, genetic variation, you know, there's XXY, XO, XY, XX, XO, and you know, 45X, 46XY, 45X, 46XX, 45X, oh, period. Nothing else there. there's 48XXXY, you know, 49XXXXY, kind of thing. You know, very rare genetic variation. No, that's just chromosomes. You know, there's lots of conditions with genetic errors in them that make us different than normal men and women. And unfortunately, our children aren't taught that there are more than just X, Y, and XX. And we need to teach them that we come in all shapes and sizes, in all colors. None of us is more privileged than the other. You know? Because I think there are a lot of kids who don't know enough information and make stupid mistakes that they wouldn't have if they had been taught that there are differences in all of us that make us unique. You know, too many people who use homosexuality, claiming it's a sin because the Bible says them, you know, says it so. Too many people who use race, you know, to promote, you know, segregation still in this day and age, to promote cleansing of culturally different, diverse groups of people. Somewhere, you know, in their past, there have been people, there still are people, who teach misinformation to get people to agree with them on what the truth is. Well, here's the truth. We are unique people. Each and every single one of us is different from the next person beside us. I'm intersexed. I'm born that way. You know, intersex, true hermaphrodite. It just means I have both ovarian and testicular tissue. You know, it's not that rare. You know, it's considered rare because it's, you know, not that common. But it's me, you know. My body's my body, not my parents' body. It's not the doctor's body. You know, I get to do the best that I can with what I have. you know, try to find a place in society to do something good. Well, you know, I think every person needs to find something in our society to do some good. Not everyone has the mentality to do good, you know. But if our children, not my children, because I can't have any, but children, you know, your children, your friends' children, you know, your neighbor down the street's children, they need to be taught that there are unique gifts and talents in each of us, that there's no reason to mock, tease, bully, or shame someone because they are different than yourself. Children need to be taught to respect each other, you know, not just respect adults because they're older, and you know, or not just to respect policemen because, you know, they're an authority figure. You know, you need to respect each and every person that they ever come into contact with. You know, too much misinformation only breeds bigotry. Too much incomplete information only breeds stupidity. If people are taught all the different variations that there are, you know, in our society, you know, if they're taught when they're young that, you know, people have conditions that make them different, you still need to accept them for who they are. You know, you can still be their friend. They can still be your friend. You can trust them. You know, they can trust you. I think if children are taught respect, that our society can be a whole lot better. Unfortunately, what they're taught is incomplete information, which is amazing, especially coming from our school systems. You know, our teachers don't teach us math problems, but only teach three quarters of you know, how to solve the math problem. You know, they don't teach you that if you get a partial answer, your answer is considered correct. No, they tell you that if you have a incomplete correct answer, you're wrong. You know what I mean? If 3 + 5 = 8, then an answer of 7 is wrong. Men are not just XY, women are not just XX. There are XX males, there are XY females, and there are XXY females and XXY males, and there's, you know, a whole bunch of conditions and genetic variations and defects that make a person whatever they are. And none of us get to decide who is or isn't a man or a woman because of their genetics or because of what they look like. Medical world calls that the phenotype. Phenotype is what you look like. Genotype, it's basically your DNA. It's your genetic code kind of thing. My genetic code is 45X, 46XY. You know, I also have COC, congenital adrenal hyperplasia. You know, you don't learn about those things when you're a kid. You know, well, some people might, but it's pretty rare because we're not taught that information. You know, and I think people, our kids, our school systems should teach those things so that people aren't so judgmental when they meet someone who is just a little bit different. You know, our world can be a better place when the bullying stops. Our world will be a better place when the random beatings, the name calling, the mocking and teasing stops. Suicide will drop when all of that happens. Until then, people are hurting and suffering at the things that they are taught is okay. Mocking, teasing, ridiculing, harassing, assaulting another person, another human being, is not okay. Take care.